India is awakening to design today, and there are some 1500 designers that are coming up every year out of design colleges. They go and work into huge corporates, they work with FMCGs, they work with the banking and finance sector, with the IT sector. There are loads of designers that are working, which include product designers, fashion designers, UX designers, UI designers, and people so and so. So who is going to manage this? Who is going to manage the designers? Who is going to reply to the business management? Who is going to convert the design into money and vice versa? So we do need design managers who will take care of both, who will understand both, who will understand design processes, who will also understand design management. I am Sallika. I am the Dean of School of Management in World University of Design. You must be wondering, what is the School of Management doing in World University of Design? We are here with two programs, which is BBA and MBA into Design Strategy and Management, and another program in Retail Business Management. Also, we have an MBA in Design Strategy and Management. So let me tell you a little bit more about these programs.
Let me tell you what is Strategic Design Management. Let's talk of each word at a time. What is strategy? Strategy is formulating a decision based on various aspects which we know earlier and what we foresee would happen next. I'll give you a very small example. Supposing you are trying to decide where are you going for your vacation. You might think you might go by what vehicle, maybe by a car, maybe by a flight. You'll go with XYZ people, maybe friends, maybe family. This is a very small decision that you take at a very personal level. That itself is called as a strategy formulation. But if you want to create this strategy for a bigger organization, maybe you want to decide that what should the color of the shampoo be of a very big brand. For that, you will have to understand what are the various factors affecting the shampoo color. What are the various kind of people who will be utilizing the shampoo? What are the various markets that will be going to, right? So all this is taken care in strategy formulation, and this is exactly what we teach in strategy design management. So let's see, what is design strategy? The strategy which is formulated with the help of design principles is design strategy. Does that mean you have to draw? Does that mean you have to hold a pencil? Does that mean you have to create a new product? No, it just means you need to understand what are the design processes. You need to understand what are the design terminologies. And very importantly, you need to understand what is design thinking and how is it applied into strategy formulation. Now the third word, which is management, is definitely understood by everyone. We all know that management as a faculty of learning has been existing for long. So basic principles of management are taught here, basic generic management subjects are taught here, which involves your macroeconomics, business mathematics, it involves statistics, it involves macroeconomics, with the subjects which are related to design as well, which is more of IPR studies, strategy formulation and design processes, etc. So what are the applications of design strategy and management into everyday industry? These people who come out of the design strategy and management courses work directly with AVP, VP level people of various companies like FMCG, BFS, IT, Manlog and other sectors also. They work in design-led businesses like Facebook, say Instagram, and there are various companies which are design-led like Tesla, GM, etc. This is where design strategies work. They also work as innovation capacity building people into BFS, that is banking and finance sector. Then they are very good at making design audits, which helps the other designers to come up with products, to come up with new product development into various industries. The design strategists also work as design researchers with various research firms such as MIT, then OZA, etc. 100 designers per year, while other countries like China have 1500 industrial design colleges in their country. That is where we are still a number behind other countries, but we do have a sizable number to look up to. That is where we need design managers who will know how to convert design insights into the monetary ROI and also how to convert monetary ROI into design processes and new product development related to design. Designers is a major task which needs to be done by the management people.
But if the management has come from the generic management education, they would not understand design processes. They would not understand the psyche of designers. They would not understand why a particular dot is placed where it is. So that needs to be understood by a person who understands both design as well as management. This is what we teach into our BBA, that is undergraduate program in strategic design management, and MBA, which is a postgraduate program into strategic design management. The industry is taking its own shape and we see various brands coming in, Walmart just stepping it into India. This also means that we do need retail business managers. This is where we have a program into undergraduate program, which is BBA into retail business management. Herein we will be covering generic management subject with specialized retail subject. Again, this is not a retail design course, but it is more of a retail management course. So we also have subjects wherein the students will learn about retail management, which will enable them to take their own family held businesses ahead, which will also help them with new sources of marketing and management, which is digital management, SEO management, etc. This course in itself is a complete holistic course which will help students to come out and start working with retail giants like ITC, now Walmart, and places wherein they can take care of stores together. The management courses occurring in a design university, how does it help both the designers as well as the managers who are being formed over here? We have an open studio system in which students from one design school can get into another design school studio and see what is happening. Thus, the design managers or the retail business managers who are being honed here can go and check what is happening in the ceramic studio. They can go and check what is happening in the fashion studio, into the architecture studio. That itself will give them a co-learning experience that will make them understand what are the design processes that occur, that will make them understand the vocabulary and also the design principles along with the theory classes that they take. Yes, they are not expected to draw, they are not expected to hold a pencil, but they are expected to understand the designer. And this will happen only if they are exposed to designers and design processes, design projects right now here at their education level.